Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Today is Wednesday, November 8th, 2006. This is your daily video technical briefing. Currently, we're looking at the British pound, but let's switch over to the currency scan. And this is what the currency markets look like at 8 a.m. Eastern Time, right as the U.S. session was beginning. And as you can see across the board, looks like we had a top here, a bottom here, and a bottom here. So the first thing I'm thinking, especially if they're confirmed by 5-8 crosses, that that the pound wants to go down, Swissy wants to go up, yen wants to go up, euro wants to go down. All right, correlation. I'm looking at correlation here, and I'm looking at the previous top, and everything seems to be in line. Okay, not much news on the calendar today. In fact, the only news is oil inventories, and it's several hours later. So this is starting to look good to me. So I need to make sure that there's full correlation before I pull the trigger. Right now, the British pound is taking the lead, and it's at the 200 EMA. So there's no reason to do anything until it breaks the 200 EMA. When it breaks the 200 EMA, then I want to make sure all the other currencies are going with it, and that the British pound isn't just doing a fake out. Okay, so that was the key here. And what happened? Well, it looks like the pound has taken the lead, and the other currencies are certainly thinking about it. But you see that the British pound has already broken the 200 EMA, so it's definitely taking the lead. But the other currencies are just approaching the 200 EMA. So the plan is wait for these other three currencies to break the 200 EMA. If they do, then we'll go with the direction of the overall trend. In this case, what's happening is US dollar strength across the board. Okay, so basically you're buying dollars, but I need to see correlation on the other three majors before I start trading. So let's zoom in to the actual British pound and see what happened. Okay, so that's where we are now, and you can see again it's exactly where we were on the other chart. We just broke the 200 EMA and it's taken the lead. Okay, let's back out a little bit and I'll show you what that black line is. This goes back to yesterday, and in fact even the day before, and we definitely have some sort of support there. Great, we need to keep our eye on that. No need to trade the pound on the short side until it breaks that. Good to know, huh? The other thing you can do is take this swing high and that swing high, and now we have a triangle. Okay, so the general plan is we want a short on a break of this line here. We'll go long here. Now that's extremely conservative, okay? But I'm an extremely conservative trader. So let me zoom in so you have a better look. Oh, and remember, we're looking for more than just a break of the lower part of the triangle. We need full currency correlation with the other majors. So we'll only trade a break of the bottom part of this triangle to the downside if the other three majors also break their 200 EMA. Let's take a look at what happened on the pound. There it is, right on top of the triangle. Is it going to break? Huh, no. Boom! Okay, now it's broke. Okay, and it looks like it's, what, 1345? Let's take a look at what happened on the euro. Okay, let me zoom in. Well, actually, before I zoom in, let's back out all the way. Very similar to that pound. Huh? You see that? Very similar support line. So let's draw a triangle here, connecting this swing high with that swing high. Very similar, huh? Yeah. So it would have been the same plan. I'm looking for the correlation. Again, I'm waiting to see if the euro is willing to break the 200 EMA. Let's see if it does. Oh, let me zoom in. Maybe you can't see it. We're right on that 200 EMA. Interesting, huh? Well, let's go back to the major currency scan. Okay, and there's the break that we've already seen on the pound. Let's move forward. There we are in the euro. We're right on top of the 200. What's the Swissie doing? Right on top. Boom. Okay, so the yen wants to go long. It looks like it's going to break the 200 EMA. Swissie right on top of it. Euro right on top of it. And you can see that not only has the British pound broke the 200 EMA, it retraced back to it. Now it's making continuation patterns. So boom, 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 boom. If you're not already in, it's about to happen. We're at the crossroads. Okay? Now the yen is kind of confirming that it's a good idea. Now the yen is breaking. Now the Swissie should break and the euros should break. As soon as they break the 200 DMA, then we have full currency correlation across the board, and you short, short, buy, buy. Let's go back to the euro and see what happened. Da-da-da-da-da-da. Boom! So now you're shorting the euro, but you also now have permission to short the pound. Why? Because there's correlation. Okay? Now you could also, let me go back to the currency scan. In this case, you could also buy the USD Swiss franc and buy the USD yen. Remember, because it's all the same analysis, it's dollar strength, which will push this currency up, this currency up, this currency pair down, this currency pair down, right? Since the dollar is gaining strength, it'll buy more Swiss francs and it will buy more yen. But because the dollar is getting more and more expensive, British pounds buy less of them and euros buy less of them. You see what I mean? But it's all US dollar here. All US dollar. That's the only thing that's happening. We got full currency correlation, which means you can feel quite confident when you sell, sell, buy, buy. All right? But I focus mostly on the pound and the euro today. Since the pound took the lead, let's take a look at what happened. And there we go. Down, 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 down. Now the aggressive target was just below here. It was 0.00, 1900. We didn't quite make it. The reason I had that target there, you see this line here on the 1 hour chart? That's the 200 EMA on the hourly. So our target was 1900 because the 200 EMA on the hourly. And the low of the chart here was 19005. Oh man. Well, don't worry. Don't cry for me, Argentina. Still picked up 20-25 pips on this. Okay. So we're there to there. Not too bad. What happened on the USD Euro USD? Okay. And look at that. How lovely is that? Why didn't it break? Well, first of all, it went just as far as the pound did, almost hit the aggressive target on the hourly chart, which makes sense to me. And right when the pound is finding bottom, look what was happening to the USD yen. Sorry, Euro USD. I'll show you. See here? Look, it ran into a pivot point, but more importantly, that pivot point was also the bottom of our triangle. Support that has lasted one, two, three, almost 4 days in a row. Okay, so that makes logical sense. What happened was we tried to break it, tried to break it, tried to break it, tried to break it, and I wimped out right here, and then boom, it totally reversed. So I was lucky to get out here, but really, you can imagine that we watched this area right here for 45 minutes. Okay, and what happened was this just didn't go after 45 minutes, so I wimped out as soon as it made a higher high. Right there, I wimped out, didn't want to hold it any longer. I mean, 45 minutes is quite a long time when you're watching a 15-minute chart. And I got out there. I got out at the pound because the pound was hesitating right when you would expect it to. Almost got my aggressive target, so I thought, well, I'm sitting on like 40 pips or something, and it's wimping out right kind of where it shouldn't wimp out if it's going to continue. Stochastics had already crossed and was pointing to the upside right here. You know, things weren't looking too pretty anymore. So I said, you know what, I'm going to wimp out. And I told people, I said, look, I'm getting out emotionally, not necessarily logically, only because, you know, I feel like it's going to end because of stochastics, because it sat here for 45 minutes. We don't have a bullish engulfing candle. The 5 still looks like it's in control, but, you know, I'm going to move my stops and yada, yada, yada. And sure enough, I get out here, and then what happened seconds later? I was laughing all the way to the bank, right? So that one I got, you know, I guess you could say I got lucky on. But the thing is, everything was lining up where it just didn't look like it was going to head down anymore. And we gave it 45 minutes. I mean, come on, right? Just wimped out, fine. Took profit, and the market reversed. Probably because there was 1,000 other people that did exactly what I did in that situation, okay? Because they could see the triangle, and they saw that as support. And they saw the 200 EMA on the British pound hourly, so they got out there, you know. So it all kind of makes sense. Now, the second trade that we did today was based on the news, okay. The news today is oil inventory, so we trade the CAD. On the left, you see the USD CAD. On the right, you see CAD yen, okay. Now, these are five-minute charts because we traded it as the news came out. Now, the general strategy is we trade our fundamentals technically, which means we ignore the first five-minute candle. We use that five-minute candle to identify support and resistance, and then we trade a break of it, right? So that's what we did today. What happened? Da-da-da-da. Boom. Okay, kind of looks like the market's going to go down, right? Da-da-da-da. Boom. Okay, those are the news candles. Don't have to freak out. And if I back out, you can see there's a fib level there. I'm trying to see what it is. It must be on something different. But what you want to measure here is this top to there. Okay? And you see basically a 382 bounce on this swing after the news. And now we're having a higher high. So if there's a high, if price continues above this candle, you go long. Target is the 1618, ideally, right? A 382 to a 1618. Makes sense to me. I teach it. We watch it over and over and over again. And, well, let's see what happened. As long as this currency pair is going to go up, ideally this one's going to come down, right? Canadian dollar strength, right? Okay, so remember how the last trade, you could have traded 4 different currency pairs and it was all U.S. dollar. Now, this is oil news. The Canadian dollar's value has an 80% correlation to the price of oil. This is oil news. So, so trading these currency pairs is all about the Canadian dollar. So what happened on the right against the yen? Boom. Okay, so you're in at 30. And it went straight to the past the 121.4 to the 1382. What happened next? Sideways, boom! All the way to the 1618, and you're out. I even played a little sound here. Danger. Why would I well, first of all, that's our target, 1618, right? But more importantly, what happened on the USD CAD? Down, right? Remember, a lower low, so that means you're selling here, so you're profitable. Now you're in the hole a little bit. Are you sweating bullets? No, you weren't, because it looked like the 5 was in control on the CAD yen, and the 5 is probably going to stay in control, and this is just a little retracement on the USD CAD, so you weren't freaking out. And boom, there's a continuation. Boom, boom, boom. Down she comes, right? So why did I caution people right at 104.49? Well, not only was that our target to take profit right in there, but this was a support. This is the S1 pivot point right there, right as we were hitting our target, which is a logical top. The USD CAD was hitting a logical bottom. All right, great time to get out, great time to take profit for multiple reasons. And let me get rid of the drawing tool. So what happened after that? Nothing happened after that. What happened after this? Went up a little bit. It hit the 1618 again. Okay. And then hesitated. Now we've got 5-8 crosses, stochastic going in the opposite direction. So there you go. So two trades. Well, actually, you could have made as many as 6 trades today based on analysis of two different currencies. The first analysis was done on the U.S. dollar, and we had full currency correlation, which means you could have made 4 trades all based on the same analysis. Boom, 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 all buying U.S. dollars across the board. We played it very conservatively, and it produced a lot of pips, quite logically. The second trade was based on news. We traded that fundamental announcement technically. That was all about the CAD, and we bought Canadian dollars versus yen and sold U.S. dollars versus Canadian dollars. Bada bing, bada boom. One went all the way to the one, did a 3-2 retracement to a 1618 Fibonacci extension. The other one went to an S1 pivot point. Pretty straightforward technical analysis today. And today is Wednesday, November 8th, 2006, and this has been your daily video technical briefing by FX Bootcamp.